The RBI's latest notification easing lending norms for houses below 65 lakh rupees in metros has redefined affordable housing. But while the move has got a thumbs up from the majority of the industry, it has also raised concerns about low-cost housing taking a backseat. Will this move further discourage banks from financing low-cost housing? Onitam Ojha finds out.
Never before did the realty sector manage to grab so much attention from the government and the central bank. It's not just the budget announcements. The sector got a shot in the arm when RBI eased lending norms for houses in the below 65 lakh rupees category. Long-term bonds raised by banks for affordable housing in this segment with a minimum maturity period of 7 years has been exempt from mandatory reserve requirements and priority sector lending targets.
Actual value is being recognized. Affordable housing is no longer 25-30 lakhs. In metros, definitely it's something like what they mentioned, 65 lakhs is the affordable housing segment, and loans up to 50 lakhs are being taken by almost everyone. So the fact that it's being recognized as affordable housing sector and being given infrastructure status will definitely give a huge boost to that particular segment.
The new norms will cover housing loans of up to 50 lakh rupees for houses costing up to 65 lakh rupees in the 6 metros of Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai, Kolkata, Bengaluru and Hyderabad, and 40 lakh rupees for houses with a price tag of up to 50 lakh rupees in other locations. Here is a snapshot of housing stock in the metros in the 65 lakh rupees category. 1,120 projects were launched in Hyderabad with total 1,03,744 units. In Mumbai, 24 projects with 3,178 units were launched. Bengaluru launched 1,675 with a total of 1,98,763 units. Chennai launched 1,110 projects with 1,27,861 units. Kolkata launched 779 projects with 88,326 units. While majority of the real estate industry and bankers are ecstatic about the RBI norms, some section of the industry feel this might not augur well for the sub 20 or 15 lakh rupees low-cost housing segment.
Suspect it's not so good for the social housing segment, which is the less than 15 lakh segment, because anyway banks are in a way figuring out how to lend to this segment, and by making it easy for them to actually lend to the 40, 50 lakh segment, I suspect it takes away the focus from the sub 15 lakh segment.
The money will move obviously to the higher end, which is easier to service, rather than the lower end, which might be a taxi driver or people informally employed who do not have, you know, documentation to prove their credit worthiness. So that segment might get actually impacted negatively by this amount being increased from 25 lakhs to 50 lakhs.
Banks are already encouraging lending to LIG and MIG because these loans are classified for priority sector loan, and priority sector requirement still continues to be 40%. So it will not discourage the banks, rather the banks will be encouraged to fund the developer also.
While the RBI has done its bit to boost the mid-segment housing, private players are clear about what the centre and the state governments need to do to give the necessary boost to LIG EWS housing.
Affordable housing, a single window clearance. Approval should be very easy. Right, so remove that barrier to entry. And the second thing is, how do you incentivize them? I'm saying show them the money. Right? Give them tax benefits and show them that they can actually make money doing affordable housing.
A step in the right direction by RBI. But will this dilute the government's plans for low-cost housing? A lot will depend on what the government announces next. In New Delhi, Onita Moja, NDTV.